why you're saying that you will ask if you don't like where you're going, you won't go. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Good.
You have to be somewhere stopped and hold on to the girls that you want.
Grandma,
do you want me to mention how far away from our parents we were getting?
It's all natural stuff.
You look Mexican, but you're wearing security guard uniform.
Where are your parents, little girls?
I looked around. I couldn't see them anywhere. I looked at my friends. She looked worried, too. We don't really know. They were just behind us lying down. I guess we didn't see them.
Come, we'll go look around again. Come on.
I was a little reluctant to follow at first, but my friends were ready. It must have been possible. I think we're the ones who are going to go alone again. I finally caught up to them.
No. We go look on camera off beach. Come on, no more questions. I help you.
I shut up. But then I realized he was leading us to a white man with hair and blood on him. I immediately knew I should have followed. I grabbed my friend's arm and I ran for it. She was shocked and let go. Then she realized something was wrong with him. She ran. It didn't take long for him to catch up to us. We're the only ones on the parking lot and no one was around to hear us scream. He threw us in the van, locked us in. I was screaming for so long. She tried to cry, no one heard me back. She was crying so long. She threw us off and fell asleep. I had a lot of accidents eventually passed up too. When I woke up, we were still driving. I couldn't tell if it was dark outside or not. I woke my friend up. Wake up! Wake up! I shoved her around for a little bit and she eventually woke up too. She grabbed onto my arm and started crying. Then a man walked in. Two men. They pinned us down, tied our hands and feet, put duct tape on our mouths, and
carried her
to my door. I started screaming, not really saying anything. He kicked me in the stomach and it was cute. I knew we were alone when I started crying. My friend started crying. 10 minutes later, another man walked in. He took my
hand and feet. Don't take the blindfold off until I leave the room. Understand?
Yes, yes. He took the duct tape off the nose and he left the room. We looked around and noticed we weren't alone. There were girls of all ages all around us. Some were sleeping and some were just staring at us. There was one girl with a baby strapped to her chest. She was only a few years older than us. I remember thinking this was what hell was. A couple weeks later, a man came and it took my friend. I never saw her again.
Unload me. Unload, like I was a package, not a human. I was taken off the train and put into a car. We drove for what seemed like forever. We finally stopped, and I was pushed into a house, and shoved up several flights of stairs, and into a room with 10 or 12 other girls. I spent years in this room, with daily rapes and beatings. Every day, at least six men would come into the cold, dark holding room and choose me to escort them. I was raped and beaten until I was emotionally numb. Then one day, when the next man came into the room and chose me, I refused to go with him. Then another man came into the room and hit me more times than I can count. But I still wouldn't go. Finally, the man threw me against the wall. All life comes to an end. All life. But why my life? Why here? Why like this?
Back in Mexico, my family and I were suffering from poverty and disease. I was only 15 when my parents sold me to a strange man for a couple hundred dollars. When I arrived at the airport in Southern California, he took me to an old Viva car, and then he told me that I owed him for letting me do this, for giving me an opportunity to help my family. But those were lies. He took me to a small rundown factory where I was forced to sew dresses from 4:30 to 12 o'clock at night. And if I didn't sew fast enough or produce things to their satisfaction, they would beat me or take away my meals for an entire day. And I couldn't leave the factory. And taking a shower meant pouring a pitcher of water all over my body. The sleeping conditions, they were horrible. The other women and I, we had to sleep on the floor with nothing but a blanket. And the rooms had cockroaches. And after a year of this torture, I just grew numb. I didn't care anymore. I lost hope. But then one day, I heard rumors that a girl from the factory had been raped. And I knew I had to get out before something like that happened to me. I ended up jumping out of a two-story window. And when I hit the ground, I blacked out. I woke up in the hospital with a broken leg and some hand and teeth fractures. But even though I was in extreme pain and would probably suffer for the rest of my life, the jump from the factory window saved my life. The hospital authorities called the cops, and I was deported back to Mexico, where I shared my story with the rest of my village so that they wouldn't have to suffer the cruel fate that I did.
$15.5 billion in industrialized countries.